I'm Cameron Chell, and I'm chairman of Draganfly. At Draganfly, we love to innovate. We were the first company to save a life with a human drone. In fact, we were the first company to develop the quadcopter drone. We have many firsts in 26 of our patents. We're the first company to have a drone inducted into the Smithsonian. And just recently, we're the first company to be fully integrated with the Baja Trucker. Innovation in the UAV space is already amongst us. We can easily think about things like autonomous flight, autonomous security, beyond line of sight, anti-drone technology, communication, and delivery. Many of the innovations that are coming in the UAV space are already imagined and here, and we're starting to see a lot of the promise for what they are. When you get into mission-critical situations and you've got to start worrying about winds and weight and battery time, software systems and autopilots and collision avoidance, and you've got to do it in a way that's 100% safe or mission-critical, it becomes a different game very, very quickly. And it's why, frankly, there have been so many drone startups that have not succeeded, regardless of the amount of money that's been put behind them. All of these things are entirely possible technically. And really what the market commercially is doing right now is catching up with itself and letting the regulators have their say to ensure that this can be a long-term viable commercial and military option as we move forward.
A lot of people are going to be watching the markets tomorrow.
As we see what's happened after this drone attack, drone strikes on the world's largest oil plant in Saudi Arabia yesterday,
Houthi rebels claiming responsibility.
The U.S. Department of Homeland Security has issued strong concern that Chinese-made drones may be sending flight data back to China. According to CNN, U.S. companies have been warned to exercise caution when buying devices which could, quote, transfer American data into an authoritarian state which permits its intelligence services to have unfettered access to such information.
Stark warning tonight from the Department of Homeland Security about the danger of drones.
In the wrong hands, they're a real threat.
Drones to drop bombs. And last year, Venezuela's president was attacked by two drones packed with explosives.
A tactic U.S. officials worry about.
The new weapon in the ISIS arsenal isn't on the battlefield, but above it, with dead center accuracy.
Lester, Department of Homeland Security officials tell us this is a big problem. They don't even know how many drones are in the sky at any one time in the United States. But they are investing heavily in technologies to both find the drones and, if necessary, bring them down.
Patrick Imbasciani, Vice President of Business Development, Draganfly. As a former Marine who had done 8 years, I've always had an affinity for technology that was in service of the country, technology that could serve public safety, EMS, emergency response. Having found that Draganfly was firmly rooted in that space, was a pleasant surprise for me. We were principally North American-centric, and our focus originally was in agriculture. Over time, I was able to help expand us into other markets, insurance, energy, utility inspection, and public safety.
Some law enforcement agencies are looking to the skies and determining that unmanned aircraft systems, UAS, offer solutions to maintaining public safety and processing crime scenes.
Sheriff's Office in Grand Junction, Colorado,
uses UASs primarily to assist in crime scene and traffic accident investigations.
The fact that Draganfly has had a 20-year run in public safety has credits to its reputation, like being the first drone to have rescued someone with the Royal Canadian Mounted Police, and actually has a drone in the Smithsonian. It was pretty impressive.
Draganfly has a substantial portfolio in the drone space, 26 patents and certainly counting. But as it relates to drones, it's very significant. We're not the type of engineering-based company that creates patents for the sake of patents. We want patents that are meaningful and really are applicable into the use cases that we're building. So our patents include things like folding wings or propellers that come off, or battery management systems. Some of the really, really basic things that pretty much in one way or another, all drones utilize. We also have machine vision patents and tracking system patents and a number of other things that get highly specialized. But we're really proud and work hard, not just having a sizable patent portfolio, but having a meaningful patent portfolio. We today really see the opportunity for Draganfly because, frankly, we're first, but honestly, we're one of the last men standing. We're one of the last companies that can actually go out and viably provide a North American-built drone solution for a critical industry.